Hi guys, it's Marty here, and in this video I'm going to show you how to install WordPress on Bluehost web hosting, step by step. And for anyone who doesn't know already, Bluehost are one of the most popular hosting companies for WordPress. We get a free domain name with all of their hosting packages, and they're even recommended by WordPress themselves as their top choice for hosting. If you already have a Bluehost account and just want to know how to install WordPress, you can skip ahead to the time on screen now. Then, for everyone else, we're going to open up our internet browser and go to bluehost.com. Or if you want to support me and this channel, you can click my affiliate link in the video description or visit the URL on screen now to get here instead. I will earn a small commission if you do this, and you'll also get the discounted price. This really does help out a lot, so thank you in advance if you use my link, and I hope you enjoy the video. Then, either way, once we get here, we're going to hover over where it says Web Hosting at the top, and then click into Web Hosting. Then on this page, we're going to click where it says View Plans, and this will show us all the different hosting plans that Bluehost offer. Now, to be totally honest, if this is your first website, you're probably only going to need the basic plan. This allows up to 10 websites, with up to 40,000 visitors per month. And this is going to be enough for most people. But if for whatever reason we need more than this, we can always go for the Choice Plus plan instead, which allows us to have up to 50 websites and up to 200,000 visitors per month. And both of these plans come with a free domain name for the first year, which is awesome. Now, as I'm only doing this for the tutorial, I'm going to go for the basic plan. And then once we've decided on the hosting plan we want, we can click Select underneath. Then on this page, we're going to register the domain name we want for our new website. So we just need to type the domain name we're wanting to register into this box, including the domain extension. And for mine, I'm going to type martyswebsite.com. And then once we're done, we need to click Search for Domain on the right. And as long as the domain name is available, we're going to see a page that looks like this. But if we get a message saying the domain is not available, we're going to need to choose something else. Then, once we know our domain is available, and we're on this page, here at the top we can see the hosting plan we chose, and we can change how often we'd like to pay for our hosting, here if we like, but I'm going to leave this set to yearly, as this way we get a free domain name and a much better discount. Then under this we have our domain name, and we can see we're getting 1 year for free, which would normally cost us $12.99. Then under our domain name we have two optional add-ons, which are domain privacy and professional email. But as we don't need these to build our website, we just need to click the trash icon to the right of each one to remove them from our order. Then, once we're finished here, we can see the total price to pay over on the right. So, as we can see, after the discount, it's only going to cost me $35.40 for 12 months of hosting and my domain name. And as these are the only two things we need to pay for, it's only going to cost us $2.95 per month to run our website, which is less than a cup of coffee from Starbucks. Then, once we're happy with everything here, we just need to click Continue to checkout. Now on this page, we need to fill out our basic information, so things like our name and address. Then under this, if we scroll down, we can enter the password we want to use for logging into our Bluehost account. And then under this, we can choose our payment method. And we can choose either credit or debit card, or PayPal. If we choose credit card, we just need to enter our payment information in here and then click Submit Payment on the right. Or if we choose PayPal, we're going to click here where it says Pay with PayPal and then log into our PayPal account to pay for our order. So I'm just going to pause this video while I fill out my personal information and pay for my order, and then I'll restart the video. Okay, so that's me now back, and when I finished paying for my order, I was automatically logged into my Bluehost account. Then, once we're logged in, we can start installing WordPress. Normally, this would require us to download WordPress and then manually upload it to our hosting account and connect our domain name. But because Bluehost uses a one-click installer, we can literally install WordPress in about a minute. So to do this, we just need to click into Websites on the left, and then click Add Site over on the right. Now on this screen, we want to make sure Install WordPress is selected here, and click Continue. Then here we can enter our site title, and don't worry too much about this for now, as we can always change it again later. And then once we're done, we can click Continue. Now we need to enter the domain name we're wanting to use for our website into this box, and this is going to be the one that we just registered. So for me, I'm going to put martyswebsite.com. Then if we click Continue, Bluehost is going to start installing WordPress for us right away. This will usually only take about 60 seconds or so to complete, but sometimes it can take a little longer. Then, once WordPress has been installed, we just need to click here, where it says Edit Site, and this will open up our website in a new tab. Now, when we first install WordPress on Bluehost, we'll be prompted to use their WordPress onboarding process. But to skip over this, we're going to click at the bottom, where it says I'm following a tutorial, take me to the admin dashboard. And this will bring us into the WordPress dashboard, which is where we can start adding content and customizing our new WordPress website. Then, to visit our website, we just need to click our site title in the top left, and this will show us what WordPress looks like when we first install it. Now, don't worry if yours looks a little different than mine, as sometimes they change up the default theme. Either way, it's just going to have some demo content on it for now, but it's ready for us to start customizing and adding content to. And at this point, if we look up at the top, you might notice that this website isn't using the new domain name we registered at the start, and this is a feature of Bluehost that allows us to get started right away. Usually we would need to wait until our domain name was ready, but Bluehost assign our website a temporary URL until our domain name is pointed to their servers. If this is a new domain name, it might take a few hours to finish setting up. But once our new domain name's ready, it'll replace the temporary one right away without us needing to do anything else. Then, to get back to the dashboard, we just need to click our site title again in the top left, and this time we'll be on the main dashboard home screen. So this is what we'll normally see when we log into our WordPress website as the first time we were on the Bluehost welcome screen. So that's us now at the end, and that was how to install WordPress on Bluehost web hosting. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, please subscribe to the channel for more WordPress tutorials in future. Then finally, if you want me to show you how to build a WordPress website in less than 60 minutes, you can check out the video that's on screen now. Once again, my name's Marty from letsbuildwp.com, and thank you very much for watching.